Good morning.
Good morning.
Hello, how are you, Karen?
Aquí sigo. A little bit flu.
Oh, you got a cold.
Yes. ¿Cómo se diría tengo gripe?
I have a cold.
I have a cold.
Yes. Yeah, okay. Yes. Since yesterday, or since the weekend? Since? Desde? Desde el fin de semana, since the weekend. Are you there, Karen?
Se congeló un ratito.
Espérame, creo que es mi inter. Ya vi aquí. Give me a second.
I'll be back soon.
Okay. Hello, Jacqueline. Good morning. How are you today?
I'm fine. Good. Bueno, fui a trabajar, teacher.
Not really.
Yes.
That's amazing. Wow. I like that. I like that. Great.
Teacher, ¿cómo se dice?
I have vacations.
I have vacation.
Ay, Jackie, hemos sido testigos de sus mañanas así de.
Ay, sí. Pero puedo decir, misión cumplida, teacher.
Congratulations. You are very responsible, Jacqueline, and you live here in San Salvador.
Yes.
Okay.
También se había confundido que era de Santana. No, de San Miguel,
No,
creo
de
que
San
la chica.
Miguel, de San Miguel. Hay un compañero en la noche que se llama Mauricio,
Ajá.
que él está en la no, está vive en San Miguel.
Ah.
Sí. Y yo así, no, pero Jackie no es de San Miguel, decía.
Uy, no.
She's from San Salvador. Sí.
100%
A
capitalina.
hundred, 100%. Yes. Yes. Really, really nice. Pero qué chivo que ya está de vacation.
Ay, sí,
De ahí hasta el 4, ¿verdad? January
hasta el
4th.
4. Sí.
Uy.
Ya.
Cool. That's nice. I think everybody needs to have vacations.
Yeah,
Everybody needs vacations, right?
sí, che.
Me llega, en serio.
Ay, sí. Pero aquí siempre corriendo, que estar un poquito más tarde.
Sí, al menos sí, un poquitito. Y no está con la presión de que tiene que ir al trabajo.
Ay, cabal.
Yes.
Ya se siente una gran diferencia.
Of course. What about Jessica? Hey, Jessica.
Hi.
How are you today?
Very good.
Great. Do you have to work today, Jessica? Or
Yes.
your
Yes.
vacations? Oh, okay.
Today, yes. Every day. And tomorrow, no. But I going to help to cook to my sister-in-law
Okay.
because we have banquetes para entregar.
Fests, I think is the name.
Yes. Ah, pues entonces
Really?
tenemos encargos. Más la cena de nosotros.
You have some deliveries to make tomorrow.
Cook and
To
deliveries.
cook. Oh my goodness. It will be a very tiring day tomorrow.
Yes, very tired. But it's okay because I learned too much.
I imagine. Yeah, you know how to cook,
Yeah.
right? That's nice.
Yeah. And I like to cook very much.
Oh, really? Okay.
And my son, the first one, like to, and he come with me.
He comes with you.
Yeah.
Okay. Great. He's learning too, then.
Aunque él quisiera que ya lo pusiéramos en la cocina, a cocinar. Pero
Imagino.
no, ahorita solo es vegetables, hacer bolsitas con tenedores, las cucharas, sal, las servilletas. Le compré una cosita para que selle. Exprime limones, corta verduras.
He helps.
Peel off the vegetables, and then he cooks. Yes.
That's
it really
nice.
Helped me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he actually mm-hmm. helps. That's yeah. right.
But in the little one, nah. No yet.
Not yet. Uh-huh. I mean, not yet, but probably soon. Yeah. Next year.
Maybe.
Yeah, the kids are very curious.
Yes.
Curious, and they want to learn. Welcome, everybody. Hello, Karen Ochoa. Xiomara. Hello. Hello, how are you today? Nora, good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome, welcome.
Good morning, teacher.
Carmen dijo que trajéramos algo de Navidad. Y aquí está el mío, ¿ve?
Ay, ahorita lo voy a buscar.
Me too, I forgot it. Oh, my God, no va a regañar Carmen, güey.
¿El qué?
Carmen. Dijo que trajéramos algo de Navidad. Carmen, aparte de nosotros mismos.
Yo no tengo nada de Navidad, pero ya me voy a inventar.
Ay, Hernanda, quítale al árbol y póngaselo.
Yes.
Enrollate las luces navideñas.
Yes.
Pero, algo que ponerse. Algo
que I don't know.
O que tuvieras el que llegara un, ajá, que fuera navideño, le entendí yo.
Ajá, yes. Ya vamos a ver.
Voy a ir a poner a la par del árbol ahorita.
Ya voy a ir a buscar. Ah, yes, good, good. Yeah, it's beautiful.
Esos son trabajos de Karen.
Oh,
ella
really?
Los hace, sí. Preciosidades de cosas.
He bordado.
Oh, qué precioso.
Qué
bordado, Karencita, qué hermoso.
Mira. Ese es un arte, es un don de Dios.
Sí, así sí.
Es. Eso no cualquiera lo puede hacer. Esa es paciencia.
Oh,
okay. Y eso se lo pone a qué, a un tapetito, un qué.
Que este me quedó de unos que me pidieron para una puerta. Me pidieron como y lo pusieron así en hilo colgaditos.
Sí, sí.
¿Y cuánto se tarda en hacer eso?
Depende. Eso, este es bien chiquitito. Depende del tamaño que lleve. No es siempre lo cuánto tiempo tenga.
Bien hermoso.
Siempre igual.
Bien chulos.
Yo creo que tengo otro.
Dice Merry Christmas.
Yes.
I like that.
Es lo que le digo, que Karen tiene un don con sus manos.
Uh-huh.
Es
igual que Patty, ¿verdad?
Que la Patty Alaguan, sí.
Sí, la Patty Alaguan es otra que.
Sí, yo solo le doy mis ideas y me dice, mira, ¿te gustaría esto? No, así como que no. Y ya me lo da.
Beautiful. ¡Ay!
¡Qué hermoso!
¡Qué bonito! ¡Ay, qué bonito! Ese es 3D casi.
Sí, ajá, ve.
Beautiful.
Tiene pedrería.
Ajá. ¡Qué cute! A mi mami le encantan esas cositas para decorar.
A la orden, a la orden.
Yes.
Ay, qué precioso.
Yes, yes. I will let you know.
¿Verdad?
Yes. I will let you know. Ya le voy a decir hoy. Porque a mi mami le encantan.
She le voy a mandar unas fotos.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Y eso me lo voy a poner aquí ahorita.
Carito, Karen.
Buena idea.
Hey, it's true.
Así como los hombres.
Sí, ajá.
Así.
Que los de África.
It's true. Okay, we will see in a minute. When Carmen is not here yet, but she will be here in a minute, I guess.
We will have time.
I have time because I have nothing right now. I have time to see what I can find. Yeah. Okay, so look, Jacqueline has apagado la cámara. She's looking for something. She's there looking for something. Okay. Welcome everybody to the last class of the year and the last class of this module, right? First of all, thank you so much. Thank you for everything during this module number two. You know that I really like this group. I love everyone in this group. It's amazing. I enjoy the classes with you guys. It's amazing, this class. So thank you for everything, for your patience, for your friendships, because you are really nice people. And because we try to enjoy every class. We always find the space to talk, to share, to say everything. So that's the good thing about this group. So, well, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for everything. And I hope you enjoy the holidays. I hope you enjoy with your family, with your friends. If you have vacations, relax, forget your job, forget the English class for a moment, and just relax, right? No las clases de inglés porque van la onda, ¿verdad? Pero sí lo de levantarse temprano. Sí, eso sí. Pero por lo demás, de verdad, gracias por todo y espero que la pasen súper, súper, súper bien. In your vacation.
Teacher, ¿y usted va a dar el módulo 3?
I don't know. No sé. No tengo idea. I don't know. I hope so. Creería que sí, pero no estoy segura, la verdad. Maybe.
Thank you, Nancy.
Ay, you're welcome. You're welcome.
You're very patient.
I try to.
No.
No,
muy, very, very kind. Yeah. Who is today's birthday?
Today's birthday?
Yes, who? I remember.
Somebody.
Era, yes.
Today's birthday.
I don't know.
Miren a Jacqueline.
Jacqueline.
Quiero ver.
Miren el video de Jacqueline.
Esto.
¿Saben qué les digo? Que en este grupo.
Y combinada, mira.
Sí, sí. Es muerta que sencilla. Muerta que sencilla.
Bárbara.
Y ahora voy a buscarse algo de Navidad. No tengo nada de Navidad, pero aquí tengo
la peluca.
Esa creatividad es lo importante.
Yes, yes.
Y te divertino un ratito.
Of course. Ay, no, Jacqueline. Yo que quería ponerme peluca también. Mentira, mentira. No. Okay, guys. So we are going to start. Ah, Jessica has a hat too, a Christmas hat. Yes,
y, very nice. And I say, look, my hat. Y no tenía la cámara encendida. Estoy dormida todavía, mamá.
This is great. This is funny. I was looking for the word bordado that Karen mentioned. Bordado is this word. Look. Embroidery. This is the word.
See?
Right? Okay. Great. Embroidery. Mm-hmm. Yes, that one. That one, that one. And there are some suggestions here of other words. Let's see, embroider is the action. And some other expression, right? Embroider or embroidery. Okay, so we are going to start today by working on this listening activity. We have been talking about technology problems, technology issues. So we are going to listen to this conversation and the topic is computer sales. Let's listen. Let's listen to what's happening and then we are going to answer some questions, 5 questions based on the listening activity. So first, listen, just listen to the conversation right now. Don't pay attention to questions, answers. No, just listen to the conversation to see what you can understand, what you can identify from the recording. Let's listen to this conversation.
Hello, and thank you for calling Computer Technical Support.
Yes, I have a problem.
Your call is important to us, and we will answer your call in the order that it was received. You are number
47
in the queue. Your approximate waiting time is
47
minutes.
Jason speaking. How can I help you? Oh, I'm saved. I thought I was going to have to wait all day.
Okay, what's the problem?
Yeah, well, I bought one of your laptop computers about 3 weeks ago, but it just isn't running right.
Okay, well, sorry to say, but your computer is no longer under warranty.
What?
It ran out yesterday.
What? A 3-week warranty?
Yeah, great, isn't it?
Oh.
Okay, what seems to be the problem?
Well, first of all, the thing always freezes,
yeah,
and it's crashed a zillion times.
Always. Sir?
And I think the computer's infected with spyware and the big banana Trojan virus.
That's normal.
That's my biggest concern.
Sir?
And plus, there was a ton of pre-installed third-party programs
yeah
to just clutter the computer. And I'm at my wit's end trying to get this thing to work.
Sir, I have to put you on hold.
What?
It's going to take us a minute or so to diagnose the problem.
Huh?
I'm going to transfer you to our one technician.
One? But...
Thank you for waiting. Your call is important to us. You are number 84 in the queue. Your approximate waiting time is 2 hours, 17 minutes, or whenever we get around to answering your call.
Does this experience sound familiar? Then do what I did. If your computer is holding you hostage and you can't get the service you deserve, then call Turbo Command, creators of the safest and most reliable computers and operating system on the planet. Listen, while the competition is spending all of their time trying to imitate our computer's performance and features, our company is innovating the computer industry. So why buy a computer that hiccups every time you turn it on, when you can be the owner of the sleekest and friendliest machine ever? Call us today or visit our website for more information, and let us introduce you to the ultimate computer experience.
Okay, so what kind of situation can you identify or can you recognize here? What's going on?
He lost the time of guarantee.
Okay. Mm-hmm. He like exceed.
Yes.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, he doesn't have a guarantee anymore. Very good.
No.
That's one. Mm-hmm. What's another situation that you remember? Something else that you remember from the recording? Mm-hmm. Somebody?
He speaks so fast.
They do. Yep. Yes. Yeah. Yes, they do. But they are talking about IT problems, right?
Yeah.
Tell me, does it sound like, do you think it's a commercial? This recording, do you think it's a commercial?
Maybe because they say the last minute. But
yes.
I don't know.
Sounds like a commercial. Yeah, almost like a commercial. Yes, it's true. And it's a commercial, actually. That's why the name of this recording is Computer Sales. Let me share the website with you. Okay, let's take a look at this website. Please, everybody, open the link in the chat, and you will have access to this exercise. We're going to listen to the recording one or two times, and then we're going to choose the correct answer. We have 5 different questions. Look at question number 1. What is the man's main problem with his computer? The company warranty, and we have 3 options. The conversation suggests that, and you have to choose the correct answer again, the main selling point of the second company is that, and the last one, what is the name of the second company? So let's listen to this recording one more time and answer the questions. But listen, listen first, okay? Listen first to the full recording and then choose the correct answer.
Hello, and thank you for calling Computer Technical Support.
Yes, I have a problem.
Your call is important to us, and we will answer your call in the order that it was received. You are number
47
in the queue. Your approximate waiting time is
47
minutes.
Jason speaking. How can I help you?
Oh, I'm saved. I thought I was going to have to wait all day.
Okay, what's the problem?
Yeah, well, I bought one of your laptop computers about 3 weeks ago, but it just isn't running right.
Okay, well, sorry to say, but your computer is no longer under warranty.
What?
It ran out yesterday.
What? A 3-week warranty?
Yeah, great, isn't it?
Oh.
Okay, what seems to be the problem?
Well, first of all, the thing always freezes,
yeah,
and has crashed a zillion times.
Always. Sir?
And I think the computer's infected with spyware and the big banana Trojan virus.
That's normal.
That's my biggest concern.
Sir?
And plus, there was a ton of pre-installed third-party programs
yeah
that just clutter the computer. And I'm at my wit's end trying to get this thing to work.
Sir, I have to put you on hold.
What?
It's going to take us a minute or so to diagnose the problem.
Huh?
I'm going to transfer you to our one technician.
One? One, but...
Thank you for waiting. Your call is important to us. You are number 84 in the queue. Your approximate waiting time is 2 hours, 17 minutes, or whenever we get around to answering your call.
Does this experience sound familiar? Then do what I did. If your computer is holding you hostage and you can't get the service you deserve, then call Turbo Command, creators of the safest and most reliable computers and operating system on the planet. Listen, while the competition is spending all of their time trying to imitate our computer's performance and features, our company is innovating the computer industry. So why buy a computer that hiccups every time you turn it on, when you can be the owner of the sleekest and friendliest machine ever? Call us today or visit our website for more information, and let us introduce you to the ultimate computer experience.
Okay, do you want to listen again?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, please.
Okay, great.
Yes, please.
Right away. Let me share this again because I know some of you just connected. Let me share this, okay? There you have the link.
Hello, and thank you for calling Computer Technical Support.
Yes, I have a problem.
Your call is important to us, and we will answer your call in the order that it was received. You are number
47
in the queue. Your approximate waiting time is
47
minutes.
Jason speaking. How can I help you?
Oh, I'm saved. I thought I was going to have to wait all day.
Okay, what's the problem?
Yeah, well, I bought one of your laptop computers about 3 weeks ago, but it just isn't running right.
Okay, well, sorry to say, but your computer is no longer under warranty.
What?
It ran out yesterday.
What? A 3-week warranty?
Yeah, great, isn't it?
Oh.
Okay, what seems to be the problem?
Well, first of all, the thing always freezes
yeah
and has crashed a zillion times.
Always. Sir?
And I think the computer's infected with spyware and the big banana Trojan virus.
That's normal.
That's my biggest concern.
Sir?
And plus, there was a ton of pre-installed third-party programs
yeah
that just clutter the computer. And I'm at my wit's end trying to get this thing to work.
Sir, I have to put you on hold.
What?
It's going to take us a minute or so to diagnose the problem.
Huh?
I'm going to transfer you to our one technician.
One? One, but...
Thank you for waiting. Your call is important to us. You are number 84 in the queue. Your approximate waiting time is 2 hours, 17 minutes, or whenever we get around to answering your call.
Does this experience sound familiar? Then do what I did. If your computer is holding you hostage and you can't get the service you deserve, then call Turbo Command, creators of the safest and most reliable computers and operating system on the planet. Listen, while the competition is spending all of their time trying to imitate our computer's performance and features, our company is innovating the computer industry. So why buy a computer that hiccups every time you turn it on, when you can be the owner of the sleekest and friendliest machine ever? Call us today or visit our website for more information, and let us introduce you to the ultimate computer experience.
Okay, let's see. What is the man's main problem with his computer?
He thinks the computer has a virus.
The computer has a virus, okay? That's right. Yes. What about number two? Ernesto, read number two, please.
They failed to comment.
The computer to guarantee.
Has expired.
Has expired.
Expired. Yes. Okay, do you remember how much time?
Has expired.
2 days ago.
Weeks.
3 weeks?
Weeks. Yes.
3 weeks and 2 days ago?
Warranty expired. Yes.
Yeah.
And he was like, what?
Yeah.
Warranty? What? What a computer? That's crazy. Okay, the next one. Carmen, okay. The Navideña girl. The
Christmas. Carmencita.
Hello.
Hello.
Ay, hablando. Oiga, y me suenan, ¿ve?
The conversations suggest that they are understaffed to handle customer complaints.
Yes. Let's see. That's correct. Complaints are these kind of calls. Hey, I have a problem. Help me. That's a complaint. Or this is very common in places like Dollar City, that people call or go, hey, look at my wallet. It has a problem here. Repair my wallet, please. That's a complaint. So this situation, this conversation is about a complaint. You're showing that you have a problem with something. Okay, the next one. Help me, please. Xiomara. The main?
The main selling point of the second computer is that
read the options. Read the three options.
Okay. The computers are sharper than their competitors. The products are the networks on the market. The company manufactures secure and trustworthy. What?
Trustworthy.
Trustworthy. Merchant?
Yes. There is a commercial, Xiomara. There is a commercial at the end of the conversation. What is their point? What is their objective? No idea?
Trustworthy machines.
Yes. Okay. Good. Your partners help you. Great. Trustworthy means confiable. That's the meaning of trustworthy. Okay, when we talk about machines. What about the next one? What is the name of the second company?
Turbo Command.
Turbo Command.
Turbo Command.
Turbo Command.
Okay. Turner Computers. Okay, great. Great, great, great. I know the conversation is kind of difficult, but it's because it's in the intermediate category. But they are talking about computer problems, and you understood the main idea. The main idea is computer problems, virus in the computer, a warranty, so you understood part of the conversation. If you go down, you will find an option that says transcript. If you go down in the conversation, sorry, I didn't show you this. If you go down, what is the option? It says, see listening script. Go to that option, please. See listening script. Go down in the conversation. See listening script. Click there, and you will be able to see the conversation, the real conversation over here. We have the phone recording, the caller, which is the main. Then we have technical support. After that, we have another phone recording, and then caller and narrator. The commercial, right? The commercial at the end. At the end of the conversation, you can find some vocabulary. Vocabulary that you can find in the conversation, like freeze, crash, look at this, clutter, some expressions. So what I want you to do right now is practice this conversation with a partner. Let's read the conversation with a partner and practice, right? Just practice right now. Let me see, we're gonna have a partner. Practice the conversation, please. Just a couple of minutes to practice and see the vocabulary.
Regresé.
Yeah, Kenneth is your partner. Ah, Arlette, you look nice.
Espera, que no te escucho. Espera.
Espera.
Ahorita le subo el volumen a esto, creo que no. Ahí está.
¿Ya? Yeah? Can you hear me?
Ahora sí.
You look very nice.
Yes, because now it's Christmas time.
Yes, I got my Christmas decoration too.
Look at you. ¿Cómo sigue? Del oído.
Bien, gracias a Dios.
Ay, bien. ¿Se curó?
Sí, la cosa que me dijo, Carmencita me dijo sobre unas gotas, así que ya.
¿Y ya?
Sí, ya me siento.
Ah, pues bien. Eso era, quizás te irritaste del oído. Una cosa así.
Sí,
pero son sustos.
Sí, no, yo decía, ¿qué es esto?
Pues sí.
Feo, feo, pero pues yo me siento bien, gracias.
Que me llega, me llega. Yeah. Y ahora solo vamos a hacer el test, ¿verdad?
Sí, sí, ahorita es como práctica de lo último ya del libro. Ah. Ya a las 7:20, we start the quiz.
¿Y el otro mes seguimos contigo?
Creo que sí, no estoy muy segura, depende de Jessica, a ver qué dice. Sí.
A ver qué dice la Jessica, sí. Ya le vamos a decir. Sí, sí. ¿Cuántos grupos son en principiante, teacher? Yo nunca he entendido, ¿cómo es? Son, ¿hasta cuándo pasas el número de principiante?
Son 6.
Ah, 6 y luego pasas a módulo medio.
Intermedio y son 6 otra vez.
Ah, ahí está esa, no entendía, ¿cuántos eran? 6.
6 de cada uno, ya cuando llegan al intermedio ya no son 40 horas, sino que son 50.
Ah, son más, y entonces ¿cómo hacemos? ¿Es más temprano o más o ya no hay temprano?
A las 6 siempre, pero creo que termina un poquito más tarde.
Uh-huh.
Y ya son de 2 horas y media.
Sí, es más larga, es más larga.
Para terminar en 20 días siempre.
Uh-huh. Es que son 20 días, no es todo el mes.
Se siente todo el mes porque como los weekends.
Ajá, quizás por eso, pero solo son 20 días. Solo son 20 días. Pero ya llevamos, en teoría, si terminamos son 2 este, faltaría uno más para cerrar el tercero y solo quedarían 3. Ojalá que te dejen a ti.
I hope so.
Sí.
I hope so, yes. Yes. A ver, ¿qué tal? Es que sí, a veces aquí creo que sí lo dejan a uno como 3 o 4 niveles.
Sí, lo bueno es porque le das continuidad. Al menos más o menos sabes cómo están todos tus alumnos.
Sí, 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 sí.
Y eso es bonito porque pues sí, podés enfocarte. ¿Lo vas conociendo un poquito más?
Mejorar algunas cosas y todo eso.
Uh-huh. ¿Qué te iba a preguntar? Algo te iba a preguntar, no me acuerdo qué. Siempre de los grupos. ¿Cuántos grupos manejas?
Ahorita solo este tengo, solo este grupo.
Yo pensé que estabas en la mañana y en la tarde.
Sí, terminamos la semana pasada, con los de la noche.
¿Y cómo es posible?
Sí, solo con ustedes quedamos. Es que como las fechas cambian un montón. Cambian mucho, entonces casi no empecé al mismo tiempo este grupo con el de la
empezó misma. Tarde, ¿verdad?
Sí, empezamos en momentos diferentes, entonces sí, me dijo Jessy, no vayas a faltar ni un día, me dijo, porque el 23 terminan.
Mira, eso te iba a decir, que al final la cronometría depende de cuándo inicias el grupo, ¿verdad?
Sí, no, son... me dijo así, no vayas a... sí, o sea, si ya no seguíamos, si yo faltaba un día, no sé cuándo hubiéramos seguido.
Ya no salíamos.
Ah, no, yo creo que hasta el otro año iba a quedar esa clase. Ah, no, me dijo que un fin de semana nos iba a tocar hacerla.
Si complementábamos.
Sí, me iba un día.
Sí, la lograste socar, por eso estabas un poco temblorosa por lo del oído, ¿verdad?
Sí, eso me asustó.
Sí, y dije, puya, no.
Ya te sorda.
Sí, la di, yo dije, Pero creo que son los tiempos los que ya no daban.
Cabalito.
Llegamos a Navidad.
Sí, llegamos a Navidad. Llegamos a Navidad dándole.
Sí, ya llegamos a 24 en clase.
Haciendo de este grupo, no, si yo estaba viendo, nosotros tenemos varias cuentas de Zoom.
Ajá.
En esta cuenta de Zoom habían como 5 grupos. Y solo este ha quedado, ya no hay otro.
No te creo, ¿y cómo nos ha salido eso, pues?
Yo no sé, pero solo nosotros quedamos, de los 5 que estábamos.
Imagina, increíble, yo le decía a la Blanca, pero no sé, Blanqui, hasta el 23, porque generalmente yo sé que terminan antes.
Sí, yo creo que hay unos que van a seguir la otra semana todavía.
No, entonces, es que iniciaron muy tarde, creo que muy tarde, y nosotros fuimos incluso de los primeros que mandamos los, para todos.
Sí, eso sí es súper importante, mandar la información rápido.
Y en teoría el otro, teacher, ¿va cuándo? ¿En enero qué? Las primeras semanas, creo yo, tendría que ser
las primeras semanas, no estoy segura. Todo depende de esto, de mandar los documentos.
Sí, porque no me han dicho.
Los primeros días de enero a más tardar.
¿Ah?
Los primeros días de enero a más tardar.
Yo creo, por lo menos.
O esas fechas.
Para hay que mandar los documentos.
La segunda semana o la tercera semana.
Sí, es que ahí se nos corren los tiempos.
Sí, 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 sí. Sí, porque cuando ya reciben los papeles, todos que ya tienen lo de los 20 alumnos, digamos, uh-huh, es una semana. Cuando ella ya tiene, ok, tengo 20 alumnos, una semana más.
Siempre son 20 por grupo.
En teoría.
Y los que se salen, ¿verdad? Que se van saliendo, ah, si es que algunos se salen.
Siempre pasa. Oh, vale. Right, right. Okay. Okay. I think Kenneth is waiting for you, Arlette.
But you, ah. Y la Arlette ni sabe la actividad. Feliz Navidad, Kenneth. Debo decir, mira, y el pobre Kenneth.
Yes, he is waiting for you.
Pobre Kenneth.
Le voy a decir que venga
yo, acá
con ustedes.
Yo entrando, yes. Estamos bailando, amigo, le voy a decir.
You have, okay, what they are doing is practice the conversation.
Okay.
Yes, just so, practice. Let me talk.
Send me with Blanca.
Blanca is here, yes.
Yeah, with Jessica.
No, Jessica es la llamada, creo yo, que aparece ahí. Creo que está como por teléfono allá.
Wait, let me see, Arlette.
Cuando escucho cantar los gallos, hasta más sueño me da.
Ay, sí.
La Blanquita hasta se esconde, mira, ni enciende la cámara porque ella viene, no es mañanera, mi amiga.
Vengo muy golpeada.
Let me ask Kenneth to come here.
Okay. We practice. Uh-huh.
Yep. Hello, Kenneth. You are alone.
Oh,
está en la sala principal, Arlette is your partner. She is in the main group. Okay. Maybe you can go there. ¿Puede regresarse a la sala principal? Donde dice salir de la sala. Y luego la opción salir de la sala para grupos reducidos. Mira esa opción en la pantalla. A la derecha hay un cuadrito azul. Salir de la sala.
Sí.
Ahora la opción que dice salir de la sala para grupos reducidos.
To take you a minute or so to diagnose the problem, I'm going to transfer you to our one technician.
One, but?
Thank you for waiting. You.
Mm-hmm. Hello, teacher.
Hi. You finished?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, great. Great.
There is many words I didn't know.
Many, yes. Many. Mm-hmm.
Like zillion, how do you say zillion?
Zillion.
And the, I don't know, qui, maybe?
Which one? With and.
Give me a second.
Okay. I'm at
there is. Okay, it's that, this word, how do you pronounce it?
Q.
Sorry?
Q.
Q. Q. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Q. This is new for me.
Okay.
Cillian. Cluter, I think.
Clutter, yes.
Clutter. Yeah. This.
Leak.
Slick, I think.
Yeah.
Leak, okay.
And you also say be at wits. Wits end, you said, right? Yeah, there are many expressions.
Yes.
And it's that's the good thing about this website. They show real English.
Yes, exactly.
Real conversations.
Real English. Maybe we learn of like English book. So when you know, when you talk with American people, it's like, what?
Yeah, that happens. That happens. That's the good thing about this website. You can find, if you click on listening activities, Karen, click there, please. Listening activities on top.
Here?
Yeah. You see there the different options, the different recordings they have. Click again. That is the list.
Ah, okay. Okay.
Yeah, you have easy, difficult, basic English, academic listening, all kind of recordings.
Yes.
They're really good.
I'm saving these links for late.
Yes, these vacations, if you want to take some time to study.
Yes. Or for consultas.
Questions? Yeah.
Questions, uh-huh.
Really nice. It's a really nice.
Okay.
Okay, if you finish, let's go. Let's go back to the main group.
Okay.
Jacqueline, y ese cabello.
La Jacqueline y yo somos las únicas navideñas. ¡Qué barbaridad!
Oh. ¡Qué exótica se ve, Dios mío!
¿Es César?
No, no. César.
Ayer andaba navideño, hoy no anda navideño.
Sí. Ya no.
Hola, Carmencita.
Bien, Carmencita. Bien,
Jessica, cariño. También, ¿ve?
¿Eh? ¿Dónde está la Jessica? ¡Jessica! ¡Qué chivo!
Y la Jacqueline, ya viste, ¿ve? Antes muerta.
Ay, que quiero poner un fondo también.
Sí, esa no ganó. Ponelo, amiga.
¿Y a dónde lo encuentro, eh?
Mira, Arlet, por la camarita donde dice. Nieve.
You have Arlet, down, so tienen que descargar la imagen primero.
Ajá.
Ay, no tengo.
Cabal, qué huevo.
Ve la otra Grinch. Vos ponete verde. Por Grinch.
Yo iba a venir de verde, pero ya después mejor de negro.
Ay, no. Pero no te preocupes, yo te voy a acosar este día. Te voy a poner música navideña todo el día.
Ay, no, qué horror. Me van a sacar el oído.
Oí la que quiere ser Grinch.
At work.
Soy Grinch,
bueno,
vos.
Y decía que yo era Grinch.
Ajá.
Yes, no, yes, Marvin.
Never, no.
Pero como hay Grinch, le voy a dejar trabajando todo el del 24 al 31.
Christmas, yo lo tengo.
Looking for a match.
Como no le gusta el Grinch, no le vamos a dejar la Navidad, la vamos a dejar trabajando.
Vaya.
No vale. Ah.
Yay. Okay, guys, I know that the Christmas spirit is here. Tomorrow is Christmas Eve, so everybody is happy about it. Today is the last day. That's good, okay? The last day of classes. You will enjoy your day today, tomorrow. Let's work on this very quickly. Let's work on these activities to finish the content in the book. Let's finish this. Help me to read this paragraph. Arlet wants to talk. I know. Paragraph number one, Arlet. Help me.
Okay. Thank you. Welcome to the Christmas Eve. Color. Color is important for users who need to print page
four presentation or maps, and another page where color is part of the information. Color printers can also be set to print only in black and white. Color printers are more expensive to operate since they use two ink cartridges. One color and one black ink that need to be replaced after certain number of pages. Users who don't have a specific need for color and who print a lot of pages will find a black and white printer cheaper to operate.
To operate. Thank you. Resolution. Let's see. One person to talk about resolution. Oscar. Hello, Oscar. Okay, let me ask somebody else. Mr. Crespin, Cesar. Cesar Crespin, resolution.
Resolution, print the resolution. The sharpness of text and images on paper is usually measured with dots per inch, DPA. Most inexpensive printer provides sufficient resolution for most purpose at 600 DPI.
Yeah, Jose Cruz, speed. José.
Ok, ahorita. Okay. A ver, okay, speed. If you do much printing to speed, the printer becomes important. Inexpensive printer print only about 3 to 6 sheets per minute. Color print is slower, more expensive printer are much faster.
Right, thank you. And Francisco, read about memory.
Most printers to come with a small amount of memory, for example, 1 megabyte, to can be expanded by the user. Handy, having more than the minimum amount of memory is helpful and faster when printing a page with large image or tables with line around the, around them. With the printer, this is large image.
Yes, thank you so much. Okay, so in this paragraph, you can find information about printers. They are talking about the memory, the speed, the resolution, and the color. It's a brief description, right, of printers. So we have a short exercise based on the reading. 5 different questions. So I'm gonna give you some minutes, a couple of minutes, to answer these questions individually, okay? I'm looking at you, Carmen. Okay, so you will have a couple of minutes to answer the questions. Let's do it. Answer the questions, please. This is individually, okay? Work individually right now. In the manual, this is page number 44. Page 44 in the manual, yes.
Excuse me.
Yeah?
Carmen, I love your screen.
We have a new visitor. A new participant in the class. Okay. Page 44 in the manual. Read the paragraph and answer the questions.
Mencita, bring your boyfriend.
Yeah, she brought her boyfriend. Okay, let's see. Question number one. Why is color important for some users? Anyone, any volunteer? Why?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's important because some users need to print page for presentation or maps, and others graphic, where color is part of information, of the information.
Yes. Not like the copies that teachers bring to the classroom, right? To the English class. But we need color pages. But what happens with color documents?
Graphic reports with graphic or maps or presentation with many visual content. Photographic.
Okay, yeah, photographic files.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. Good. What about number two? What does DPI stand for? What is the meaning of DPI?
Yeah, teacher.
Okay, Jacqueline.
Printing is resolution, the chapters of text and images on paper, usually mensually installed per instance, DPI. Eso lo usamos nosotros en el trabajo, teacher.
Oh, really?
Yes. Resolution de imagen de ortofotos, fotografías aéreas.
DPI entonces es importante.
La resolución tiene que ser nítida para poder dibujar.
Ah, that's interesting.
Yeah.
Interesting. But you have to, you need to have good tools, buenas herramientas, right? Good tools.
Yes. Sí. Se usa, eso se imprime. Entonces ya para los trabajadores de campo.
Sounds great.
Okay.
Great. Thank you so much, Jacqueline. Okay. With the green hair, very shiny. Okay, number three. Why are color printers more expensive? More money when you have a color printer. Why?
Me?
Uh-huh. Jessica, thank you.
Because they used to ink cartridges. One color and one blank ink.
Okay. Yes. What happens, Jessica, when you go to the photocopy center and you want to print a document in color?
The page is more expensive. When we print in black and white, One cent. And when is the color page is 50 cents.
True. Like a quarter, like a dollar.
Uh-huh. Depends. Yes.
It's true. And you are very excited sometimes. Yeah, print this document and this one. It's beautiful, the color. And when when you ask, how much is it? $4. $5 and maybe a few pages.
When we pay for this, for print a page of colors in a Cedar Cafe, is too much expensive. But when we use the print of the work, for example, we no vemos lo caro que es y lo que hacemos gastar.
To the company, yes.
Ajá, to the company.
Yeah, it's true. The company, you just print a document and automatically it comes.
And sometimes the page are mistake, and we have to print again in color and no.
It's true. So yeah, that's why to print in color is you have to be careful.
Yes.
Definitely. Okay. Or otherwise, you are going to pay more than what it costs. Okay, number four. What is something important for someone who prints a lot? What is that?
The speed. The speed is important.
Why, Karen?
Because no, me salen raíces ahí. Can you imagine printing, I don't know, 500 page? Oh my God.
A whole day?
Yes. Yes.
Like a matricial printer.
And the sound.
Oh yeah. And you are in front of the printer like this.
Mm-hmm.
Waiting for the pages to come.
Yes. Tiki, 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 tiki. Oh my God. That's horrible.
You get more desperate.
Yes.
I don't like the printers. They know when we are hurry up, and they stuck in that moment.
Yes.
No working. If, I don't know. Yes. They smell it. Uh-huh. You need to be fast for all the documents, and they stuck.
They know you are in a hurry.
See. Yes, I don't like it.
Okay.
He thinks, I think it's a good moment for a stuck.
Ooh. Uh-huh. Buck. Yes.
Uh-huh. And then when you are like, hey, can you work? They are like, ha, ha, ha.
Yeah, no, it's impossible for me every time.
Okay, and the last one, question number five. What is the amount of memory that most printers come with? According to the paragraph, what is the amount? In the last paragraph, you can find this information.
1 megabyte.
It's a small amount?
Very small amount, yes. Just 1 megabyte. I didn't know that printers had a memory. I didn't know. But now we know they have some space. Okay. Then you will see that in the manual, we have a conversation. Help me, please, to read this conversation quickly before we start the quiz. Wendy has been very quiet today. Wendy, help me. Wendy and okay. Jessica. Yeah, Wendy and Jessica, read this conversation. You start, Wendy.
Thank you for calling the IT department.
Hello, my name is Maria Ochoa, and I need to file a complaint about my work terminal.
I'm sorry to hear that. Please describe the problem.
It was very slow yesterday and it didn't turn on today.
Let me send someone with a complaint form. We can say a new computer in no time.
Thank you.
You are welcome.
Okay. Thank you, girls. Complaint. Look again, we can find this word. Complain. When we have a problem, we make a complaint. In this case, we're talking about a complaint form, a document like this. Look at this. Do you have this kind of document in your work? Complaints form? When you have a problem with the printer, with the computer, with the mouse?
No, in this form is digital.
It's digital right now?
Digital, yes.
But you can write your complaint. there.
Yes, it's something like that, but in a page, in internal page.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Of course, just for your company. So, what do you do in your case, Karen? What do you have to do in that complaint section? What kind of information do you have to complete?
What is the problem? And what area I need to attend to support me, because can be something about the system or something the hardware or something Windows or so is different.
Different, okay. Yeah, different areas.
El que lo atiende.
Different person. Okay, great. What about in Dollar City, Patricia? Do you have an area where you can show your complaint? Hello. Do you have a department, Patricia? Do you have an area where you?
Yes. We have an IT department. They support for anything problem.
And what do you do in these cases? You have to call them or you have to complete a form online?
For call.
Ah, okay. By call.
When I need support, I call the help desk department.
Okay. Great. Great, great. That's good because you have immediate help in the moment. Okay. That's fine. Thank you. So I think that different departments have all of these areas where you can make a complaint. This is an example of a complaint form. Obviously, when we were in the office, when we were in our workplace, we have this kind of documents. And you have to write the name, your name, the date, phone numbers, if it's possible, the address, and then a short description of your problem. Complaint, look at this word, complaint. Esto es como decir quejas, okay? Or when you want to report a problem, this is a word that we can use. So this is one more topic that we have in the manual. And the last one, the last topic was can and could. Look, can and could to talk about requests. If you remember, all of these days we talk about requests. Let's see these examples over here. Nora, can you help me to read these examples, please?
Could you write this report, please? Could you deliver this letter today, please? Los de abajo también, teacher.
Yes, please.
Can you write this report, please? Can you help deliver this letter today, please?
Thank you very much. So here we have could and can. What is the difference between could and can? Tell me what's the difference.
Puedes o podrías.
Puedes o podrías. Okay, very good. And in the uses, which one is more formal?
Cool is very formal. Can is informal.
Exactly. Very good. Can is informal. Could is very formal. Definitely. Polite, right? More polite. So you sound more, more formal. Yes. So the last activity before we go to the quiz, it says over here, write 5 requests. Imagine that you are having problems and you want to report the problem. Please give me 3 examples, only 3 examples, no 5, 3. 3 examples of requests using can and could. Let me show you some situations. Here, look at my situations over here. Let's take a look at the first situation. Situation 1, 2, and 3. Number 1, you want to talk to your boss and the receptionist answers the phone. What do you say in that moment? Or what do you ask? Let's make a request. Number 2, you have problems with a deleted file in your computer. How do you ask for help? And number three, you need to pay something, but you don't have money. Your coworker is with you. How do you ask your coworker to lend you a couple of dollars, like $2 or $1, I don't know. So let's create that request here in the chat. Show me those examples, 1, 2, and 3. Using can or could. Do we have a birthday person today? Whose birthday is today? Birthday today, nobody?
Jacqueline, no.
Yeah. Jacqueline is you. Your birthday today?
Yes, teacher.
Yeah. Happy birthday.
My birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Jacqueline.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Ya queremos pastel.
Yes.
Marvin le va a mandar el pastelito más tarde.
Yes, yes. Este Marvin nos tiene con ganas de pastel y hace como 2 meses.
Marvin tiene que mandarlo a domicilio el pastel.
Hay que pasarle todas las direcciones para que
vea.
No ninguno.
Sí, sí, tienes razón, Jessica.
Había un hombre que cumplía años hoy.
¿Ah?
Yo me acuerdo que también había uno de los chicos que cumplía años.
¿Ayer fue?
Ah. Ah, ayer.
Ah, Kenneth, faltó. Kenneth, era desde el 19. Era,
ajá.
Yo, pero ¿cómo saben esas cosas? Me admiran.
¿Cuándo fue?
Que lo platicamos en un ejercicio, ¿no te acuerdas?
Ah, Dios guarde, pero yo creo que no estuve.
Tenía sueño.
Estaba dormida.
Esa amiga.
Gracias a todos, gracias.
Enjoy a lot. Kenneth es el 31. I don't remember. Okay, well, let's see. Happy birthday, says in the chat. Greetings, dear Jacqueline. Okay, the last thing. Number one, you want to talk to your boss? And the receptionist answers the phone. What do you ask? Tell me. What can you ask?
Llamarle al celular.
Okay, say it in English.
Okay. Call your cell phone.
Call to his or her cell phone.
To his cell phone.
Ah, okay, his personal number. okay. One, but it's a request. Could you? Right? Can you? Could you?
Could you?
Please call to his cell phone.
Okay.
Could you tell him?
Yes, Arlette.
Could you tell him that I could, that I need to talk to your boss?
Okay, very good.
Could you talk to your boss?
Repeat, please.
Could you talk to your boss?
Talk.
Could I talk? Could I talk to your boss? Okay. Yeah, very good. What about the next situation? You have problems with a deleted file in your computer. How do you ask for help? Patricia. How do you ask for help? I have a deleted file. So, how do you ask, Patricia Rivas? Ms. Rivas? Hello, situation.
Uh-huh. I need the recover and import file.
Yeah.
I say, hi, I need to remove and import file. Can you please help?
Very good. Mm-hmm. Can you please help me?
Yes.
Very good. Can you please help me to find the deleted file? Okay. What about you, Liz? How do you ask someone to help you if you have a deleted file?
Can you help me to find my files in the hard disk, please?
Great, great, great. That's a good example of a request. Thank you. And the last one, you need to pay something, but you don't have money, and your coworker is with you. What kind of question can you make, Wendy?
Could you pay something for me, please?
Okay, good. Good, good, good. You can do that. Ernesto, how can you ask your coworker to help you pay something? Ernesto, you here? Okay.
I'm sorry. I'm here.
Situation number three, Ernesto. How do you make a request if you want to pay something that you don't have money?
I don't have an idea.
What can you say? It's here, situation three.
Hey, could you help me with money, please?
Okay, could you help me with money? Yes, that's right. That's right. You can also say lend, prestar dinero. Could you lend me? That's another word we can use. Okay, guys, with this exercise, we finish the topics in the manual. Take a look at this. This is the last topic, can and could and request. We have nothing else, just that. The end, it's the end. So, now, this is what we have in the quiz. Request, some examples of requests, and you have to identify. Not a mistake, but you have to see some sentences or questions, and you have to say if the sentences are correct or incorrect. Then we have simple present and present continuous combined. Let's remember this. Simple present is for routines, right? I work every day, I take a shower, I go to work, I have dinner with my family, I do exercise every Friday. I go to the movies on the weekend. So you talk about routines. And we also use frequency adverbs. Always, never, sometimes, usually, hardly ever. When we talk about those routines, for example, I never watch horror movies. I always go to the beach. I sometimes go to the movies. I hardly ever eat a spicy food. In those examples, I am talking about my routines, my activities, and I am also using frequency adverbs, always, never, sometimes. In those cases, I use simple present. And what is the simple present structure? Easy. In simple present, we use the subject plus the verb plus the complement, okay? This is the structure of simple present sentences, complement. And now we can include before the verb a frequency adverb. Frequency adverb, like always, never, sometimes, or usually. If we have present continuous is not for routines. Present continuous is for activities right now, activities in the future or temporary activities. What is the structure of present continuous? Let's remember. What is the structure? We have the subject, and after that, what's next? Subject plus the verb to be. What is next?
The verb.
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 ING.
Very good. Verb. Excellent. Verb in ING. And
complement.
Complement, right? For example,
I'm reading right now.
I am reading. Okay, I'm reading. Right now. We are talking in this moment. We are studying. Very good example. I'm reading right now. So that's the difference between simple present and present continuous, right? The verb and the uses, of course. Simple present for routines and present continuous for activities now, temporary activities or scheduled activities in the future. Basically, this is what we have in the quiz. Please, everybody go to Schoology in this moment. I think Schoology.
Yeah. Where is the last day to the homeworks?
The last day in the platform, here in the platform, is today, here in Schoology. Okay. But if you can send me the information during the week. But to me, personally, to me. It can
for
be
WhatsApp.
By WhatsApp. It can be by WhatsApp or by email. Yeah. Okay. But to me, because the Schoology is going to be closed after this day. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Will be closed. But you have until the weekend to work on the activities. Yes. In a Schoology, in this moment, I'm sorry for the animal. Here in Schoology, go to examine it, please. Exams, the green file over here. Please. And it's not published. Wait, not published. Okay, it is here. End of level test here. End of level test. Then you will see the option start new attempt. You have three opportunities in this occasion. Three opportunities if you have problems. So let's see. Please, when you have access to the exam, let me know in the chat. Tell me here in the chat, ready, got it, teacher. I mean, yep, okay, great, Jessica, thank you. Ready, okay, Arlette, great. Wendy is ready too, Carmen is ready. Perfect, that's perfect. Karen is ready too. Marvin is ready. Nora is ready. Oscar, very good, is ready. All right. So, activity number one is the listening activity. Okay. I'm going to play the recording and you have to choose the correct answers. Here we have the questions. Where are they planning to go? What kind of restaurant do they want to visit? Five questions, okay? Five questions based on the listening, on the recording, sorry. The next part is complete the sentences using present continuous. Present continuous, just that. In parentheses, you have the verb. You just have to complete here with present continuous. Then, number seven, activity number seven, or question number seven. you have to complete the sentences or questions in the simple present, okay? Use the correct form of the verb and the position of frequency adverbs. In parentheses, you have frequency adverbs. So you have to write in the space the correct form of the verb and the correct position for frequency adverbs. This is in simple present, no present continuous, simple present. The next activity, here we have 5 sentences and you just have to complete with either simple present or present continuous. One option, just one option is correct. This one is combined. Here, blank number one and you write, oh, my friend, I have 2 options. My friend is working or my friend works. Just 2 options. You have 2 options, but only one is correct. Only one is correct. In this case, en este caso, ¿cuál sería la correcta? My friend is working or my friend works right now?
Is working.
Is working, right? Is working. So, solo voy a dejar is working, right? Okay. The next one. Read the paragraph and then answer the questions. 4 questions based on the paragraph. Choose the correct request. Choose the correct request. And the last one is the same activity. Complete the sentences with simple present or present continuous. That's it. Okay. At eight o'clock, we finish the video call. If you want to continue later, you can do it. No problem. If you have questions, let me know in this moment. And just that. Let's play the recording. Let's work on the listening activity right now. Here. Let's listen to this recording. Y no se preocupen que voy a...
Hola.
Voy a apagar mi micro.
Perdón, lo podemos completar otro rato, ¿verdad? Yo me tengo que retirar.
Entonces,
es presente. Ernesto Martín.
Thank you, Ernesto. Thank you. Ahorita lo pongo por acá.
Gracias.
Ok. Don't worry. Yo ahí lo pongo. Ok, let's listen to this. Okay.
So, what do you want to do tomorrow?
Well, let's...
So, what do you want to do tomorrow?
Well, let's look at the city guide here.
Okay.
Here's something interesting.
Oh.
Why don't we first visit the art museum in the morning?
Okay, I like that idea. And where do you want to eat lunch?
How about going to an Indian restaurant? Hmm. The guide recommends one downtown, a few blocks from the museum.
Now that sounds great. And after that, what do you think about visiting the zoo?
Well,
it says here there are some very unique animals not found anywhere else.
Well, to tell you the truth, I'm not really interested in going there.
Really?
Yeah. Why don't we go shopping instead? There are supposed to be some really nice places to pick up souvenirs.
Nah, I don't think that's a good idea. We only have a few traveler's checks left, and I only have $50 left in cash.
No problem. We can use your credit card to pay for my new clothes.
Oh, no. I remember the last time you used my credit card for your purchases.
Oh, well. Let's take the subway down to the seashore and walk along the beach.
Now that sounds like a wonderful plan. So, what do you want to do tomorrow?
Well, let's look at the city guide here.
Okay.
Here's something interesting.
Oh.
Why don't we first visit the art museum in the morning?
Okay, I like that idea. And where do you want to eat lunch?
How about going to an Indian restaurant? Hmm. The guide recommends one downtown, a few blocks from the museum.
Now that sounds great. And after that, what do you think about visiting the zoo?
Well,
it says here there are some very unique animals not found anywhere else.
Well, to tell you the truth, I'm not really interested in going there.
Really?
Yeah, why don't we go shopping instead? There are supposed to be some really nice places to pick up souvenirs.
Nah, I don't think that's a good idea. We only have a few traveler's checks left, and I only have $50 left in cash.
No problem. We can use your credit card to pay for my new clothes.
Oh, no. I remember the last time you used my credit card for your purchases.
Oh, well. Let's take the subway down to the seashore and walk along the beach.
Now that sounds like a wonderful plan.
One more time.
So, what do you want to do tomorrow?
Well, let's look at the city guide here.
Okay.
Here's something interesting.
Oh.
Why don't we first visit the art museum in the morning?
Okay, I like that idea. And where do you want to eat lunch?
How about going to an Indian restaurant? Hmm. The guide recommends one downtown, a few blocks from the museum.
Now that sounds great. And after that, what do you think about visiting the zoo?
Well,
it says here there are some very unique animals not found anywhere else.
Well, to tell you the truth, I'm not really interested in going there.
Really?
Yeah. Why don't we go shopping instead? There are supposed to be some really nice places to pick up souvenirs.
Nah, I don't think that's a good idea. We only have a few traveler's checks left, and I only have $50 left in cash.
No problem. We can use your credit card to pay for my new clothes.
Oh, no. I remember the last time you used my credit card for your purchases.
Oh, well. Let's take the subway down to the seashore and walk along the beach.
Now that sounds like a wonderful plan.
You can repeat the recording if you want to, no problem, okay? If you have any questions, I will be here. Just let me share the link to access to this exam. There you have. In the chat, you have the link to access to this part of the exams. If you are not working in the exam yet, here. End of level test. This is the one you have to choose. And then you will have access to the exam. Questions right now? Do you have any questions? No questions?
No yet.
Okay. Great, great. If you have questions, let me know. Let me check the attendance real quick. Okay. Arlette Alonso.
Presente.
Thank you. Blanca Martinez. Blanca.
Presente.
Thank you. Carmen Elena Flores.
Present.
Thank you. Dora Lizeth Recinos.
Present.
Jacqueline del Carmen.
Present.
José Luis Cruz. Karen Hernandez.
Present.
Karen Ochoa.
Present.
Kenneth Alarcón. Kenneth is here. Marvin Peña. Marvin. Nora Ventura.
Present.
Patricia Rivas.
Marvin dijo que tenía problemas con el micrófono.
¿Quién?
Marvin.
Oh, Marvin. Ah, okay. Thank you. Wendy Latin.
Present.
Sandra Carolina Hernández.
Present.
Oscar Melara.
Present.
Jessica Alfaro. Jessica. Salvador, he said present, he was here. César Fernando.
Present.
Francisco Sigüenza.
Estoy.
En Xiomara López.
Flores, present. Sí.
Flores. Yes, oh my God, Dios mío. Yes.
Sí, pero como esta es la misma.
Siempre digo López por Zulma. Zulma López es la última en la otra lista. Sorry, Xiomara. Francisco, ¿me iba a preguntar algo?
Sí, nuestra nota que íbamos a hablar o exponer, no sé, ¿vamos a cumplir nosotros o cómo quedamos?
¿Qué nos falta? Francisco.
Nuestro grupo no pudo exponer ayer, o no sé si
expusieron. Como me aportaba ni yo.
se me iban a ir sin... No, vaya. En lo que sus compañeros hacen el quiz, you can talk right now. No problem.
Oh my God. Karen está ahí.
¿Y?
¿Saben qué? Como ya no hay otra clase después de esta, se quedan unos minutitos, no sé si pueden.
No sé si puede crear una sala para los cuatro, Jensi, y poder que medio escuche ahí lo que vamos a decir para que pueda confirmarlo, pues.
Buena idea. Sí, para que todos estén trabajando más tranquilamente. Sí. Yes, of course. Let me see.
Para no interrumpir a los compañeros.
Voy. No vayan a aceptar las invitaciones, solo los de los grupos. A ver, entonces sería Carmen, Francisco, ¿quién más está?
Karen Ochoa,
ah, ok. Karen Ochoa. Ahorita. Ok. ¿Do you see the invitation? Ya les envié la invitación, Francisco y Carmen.
Hello.
¡Qué tremendo! Les voy a poner la PPT.
Ok.
Quiero ver si se me hizo esto. Ah, no sé, aquí está. A ver. Share screen. Me avisan si la pueden ver.
Yes.
Correcto, Carmen.
Quiero ver. ¿Ven otra cosa hoy?
No, Carmen Flores, dale.
Ahorita.
Ya.
Yeah. Yes. Can start.
Okay. Good morning. We were talking about WhatsApp. Information about what the WhatsApp application is. Who I believe now it works. WhatsApp was created in 2009, thanks to the idea of one of its founders, James Cowan. In the first instance, we wanted to create an application that would allow him to send notification to friends. But then idea changed and the goal changed to creating an instant messaging application. Brian Acton, who will be the co-founders of the app, go involved in the project thanks to Cohn, who after a Brisby, Mash asked him to be his partner and together they start the project. It's concurrently has more than 1.2 billion users worldwide in owned by Mark Zuckerberg. Logons icons. WhatsApp. Espérenme, Carmencita, que se se tapa. Lo voy a poner del mío mejor. Va. Logan's icon was at us a logo that, without knowing what the application is above, tells you just be looking at it. The element of the logo are the text message in double which symbolizes. One, message sending. Two, message deliver. Three, message viewed. Four, send a voice message.
Esta vez que me cuesta pasarla. No sé por qué me cuesta pasarla.
Move el mouse.
Ay. Me fui muy allá, no. Ahí está.
Ay. Futures. WhatsApp is an application that we allow you to be in contact with your family and friends worldwide in a simpler and faster way. Her way shares some of the features that will be found in the application. You can receive and send text and voice messages, make calls and video calls to the outward only with an internet connection. With the double check, you can know if your messages reach your contact and if it's in blue, now that they have already read it. Its use is completely free. They do not use advertising in their application. The account can only be a single cell phone. You cannot enter from another cell phone simultaneously. Share state in the real time. This can be photos, video, or GIF. And you can apply filters, emoticon, or text.
Carmen, si quieres pasar a la advantage, ya lo dijo eso. Solo una slash voy a decir yo por el tiempo. Y tres partes. Advantage. Free, it can be downloaded to the virtual store, to the operating system that has the device, Play Store, Android. Without paying and kind of free, WhatsApp does not charge of the service is offered. You can send messages and make unlimited calls without any problem. You only need to have two internet connection. It does not display advertising content unlike other apps. WhatsApp does not show ads. This present a great advantage from different point of view. It is much faster than other messaging service by not having to upload advertising content. It offers a variety of service. WhatsApp offers a wide variety of services, instant messages, voice and video call, voice note and media uploads, end-to-end encryption message, image, audio send within a chat are protected with end-to-end encryption with concept of user privacy protection, system time insurance, two messages are read only by one phone number with send. Allow you to share media content, different type of media file can be shared from image to audio file and video. Important to contact from the phone, WhatsApp, import contacts directly from a device on which installed this way. You don't need to save the user to the app and by com. The platform does automatically. Vaya, si quieres dale voz, Carmen Flores, para que digas algo. Sí. Dale.
How to use it as a tool for your business. WhatsApp is the tool that will help you to expand and grow your business because it will allow you to improve the communication with your clients, obtaining efficient results. Thanks to it, your customer or consumers will have a different experience, where you will provide customer service and support quickly and easily understandable, but you have to make clear the schedule in which all queries or messages you receive at WhatsApp will be resolved. countries where it is prohibited. WhatsApp is also not unaware of the ban on its service in some countries, as are different social networks. The main reason for blocking the application comes from the government or service operators in different countries. And conclusions. WhatsApp is an application that is dedicated to sending and receiving instant messaging online, where you can send files, location, or make calls and video calls to everyone. To do this, you only need to have a cell phone number, affiliate it to the application. Your contacts will be loaded out automatically. And really, you can make unlimited use of the application. Most of its users have between 18 and 24, which are active users since they check their cell phone constantly. But in spite of that, 60% are children between 10 and 15 years old. Owen thought it is an application for people over 16 years old. This is because it is available to everyone and for iOS or and Android operators, which makes it easy for everyone to access. The progressive digitalization of service companies and industry implies access to new markets and forms of business. With a diploma in social media ads, you will be able to manage and administer social networks. In addition, you will be able to develop creative and interesting content, executing investment campaigns in the different digital platforms.
Okay. Thank you very much, guys. WhatsApp is a good
application. Thank you, teacher.
It has a lot of disadvantages and advantages.
Yes.
Congratulations. Oh my God, I'm sorry que casi se me olvida, sorry. Bueno, se me olvidó en realidad porque Francisco.
A mí se me había olvidado, ay no. Yo no había visto el chat de los niños.
I'm sorry, de verdad, I'm sorry. Pero ya.
Sí, claro. ¿Hasta qué horas tenemos para contestar el examen?
Todo el día, tienen todo el día, no hay tiempo límite.
¿Y lo puedo hacer en la noche?
Sí, no hay
problema. Ah, va. Está bien.
No problem.
Pero mañana ya no, ¿verdad? Solo hoy.
Ah, mañana. Ahí va a estar el examen. Ay, lo que pasa es que Schoology se cierra. Sí.
Ah, va. Uh-huh. Y para las tareas, teacher, a mí me faltan.
Falta, me la envía a mí.
¿La bajo? ¿Cuáles son las que voy a hacer y se las mando a usted?
Así hacemos.
Mañana se cierra Schoology.
Yo creo que ahora.
Ah.
Ahora a las 12 de la noche. De mañana. ¿Qué? A las 11 creo, más o menos.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Se cierra, sí, hoy se cierra.
Ah, vaya. Está bien, gracias, teacher.
Bueno. Vamos a la sala principal para despedirnos.
Y... ok.
Okay, you can continue working on the exam, of course, no problem, you can continue, but we are going to finish the video call, okay?
I have a question.
Tell me.
In the part number 7, you tell us simple present, but it usually and sometimes is only for the two first sentences.
Uh-huh.
And the other three,
you
don't have.
No, you don't need to write any frequency adverb. okay. Yes, don't worry. No frequency adverb.
Simple present.
A simple present, ajá. In question and negative. What is the auxiliary that you use in simple present?
Do. That.
That's depending on the subject. Yes.
Well.